positive pole. Positive pole is gonna be this side right here. The other side is a negative pole. So we took time to make, you know, to make this one by one. This is the negative side, this is the positive, right? And basically the energy starts, it comes up this way. We have our connection here. It goes down this way, back up, and out. It goes into this box right here. So, John, go to the next slide. So this is an image of the solar cell, which is each individual piece right here, right? Of course, we got the sunlight that comes in. Like it. Make sure you notice, right? When the light comes in, it hits this side, which is the negative side, the negative pole, and the electricity, again, it jumps up. And right here, these are the metal rods or strips that the electrons travel to, and then they're gonna go down to the back of the other side. Because what it is, the energy is coming from the top of this side and going to the back side of the next one. And all of them do that, so it's a wave. It goes up and down, up and down. Right? You don't have to worry about that. So the basic system would be to have, right, so let's read that. The off-grid photovoltaic system works basically with the solar modules. It's this right here. It goes into your charge controller, which is this piece. And it goes into your battery, which will then go into your inverter. So your inverter is kind of like the circuit breakers in your house. Before you get to the circuit breaker, there's a box that this system will connect to. And then it goes to the rest, you know, through the circuit breaker into the house, to the different outlets.
Okay.
It comes in, the charge controller regulates how much energy is gonna go into your battery. Once that battery is full, it sends out a message to the charge controller, and your charge controller is shut off so that it doesn't keep sending energy to the battery because it's gonna overheat. Once that battery goes 1 degree under what it's supposed to be at, it will accept charge until it's full again. Right, so we go from, now you can either have a direct current, which is when you send something directly from your light bulb and directly from your battery and light a light bulb, or you have alternating current. So we have direct current when it comes straight out, the energy is just, it's a pure flow. There's nothing stopping it or causing it to fluctuate. It's a pure flow. Most appliances are going to be alternating current AC, so it has to go through an inverter in order to power whatever that device is without blowing it up.
Which would be heat in the house also, right? Is it
heat like an AC or?
Well, you know, like in colder climates where this is, you know, they're using solar panels in order to convert, in order to heat up their house, to warm up their house.
Right.
So yeah, they don't have to pay a gas, you know, like a key gas bill or whatever.
Yeah, definitely. Anything that's, any system that you might create where the appliance requires electricity, that can power.
And the battery is what's converting this energy, this solar, this being converted into that.
The battery is just your bank. It's like you go into the bank, you put money in the bank, you know.
Uh-huh.